Would you put your cell phone down and step in to lend a New York City cop a hand? One of the police unions is proposing you do just that, and they want to pay you for it. We know that New Yorkers are good at being good Samaritans. Remember this video where a man chased down a thug who had just attacked two elderly people? Or the one where a man helped a young couple that had just fought off a man with a pipe? But jumping in to help police officers on a regular basis and getting paid for it? Nate Rodgers has the full story from New York. Nate, I gotta believe this proposal has sparked a bit of controversy.
Absolutely, Bill. It's definitely the talk of the town. This all comes on the heels of more and more cell phone videos surfacing of police-involved confrontations turned viral. Now, at a press conference earlier today, the president of the Sergeants Benevolence Association said officers are operating under an unspoken hands-off policy. He said officers are confused on how to effectively police without losing their job.
We go back several years ago to protests in the streets, pigs in a blanket, killed cops, and within days, we had two police officers here assassinated right here in the streets of Brooklyn. The impact of what has occurred over this time has created weak leadership.
Now, Bill, the program called Help a Cop will now reward Good Samaritans $500 for stepping in and aiding cops during arrests. Even though it's unclear when exactly folks should step in, the SBA says the idea is simply to help restrain the suspect, and while doing so, listen for clear instructions from the officer involved. Of course, Bill, I spoke to several residents throughout New York City today. Many of them said this is a very bad idea.
It's their job. Why do I have to get involved in something that has nothing to do with me?
I don't believe that they need our help. I believe they need to be trained better.
As a decent human being, you should try to step in if you can. But you got to judge it according to the dangerousness and the seriousness of the situation.
SBA's President Ed Mullins says people are more interested in recording cell phone videos than saving lives. People I spoke to today, Bill, said especially now with police and community relations estranged nationwide, capturing intense moments on camera could, in fact, help save a life.
Sometimes people need physical or visual proof, and so people having their phones out is able to provide that.
In a statement, NYPD said, quote, the NYPD encourages people to support their cop by calling 911. The department does not want to see people put in harm's way unnecessarily to collect a reward. And finally, Bill, the SGA is also working with Senator Martin Golden on a Good Samaritan law that protects civilians who step in to aid cops during confrontation. Bill?
Let's bring in our A-plus panel for tonight's show. Allison Young, Republican strategist, back with us. Good to see you, Allison. Matt Rooney, attorney and founder of the Save Jersey blog. You know, this is really not about actually helping cops do their job. It's more about pushing back on the administration and saying, we don't have enough cops.
Oh, sure, yeah, they're trying to make a point. I'm sympathetic with that. They have a mayor in de Blasio who's openly anti-police. So to put your life on the line every day when you're serving that kind of leadership, it's tough. By the same token, in a city where we don't even let people have guns to defend themselves, we're now going to essentially deputize everybody and ask them to intervene. It's a disaster in the making.
I mean, what happens now? So Matt, I help restrain you because you've committed, it looks like you're committing some crime. You maybe get cut or bruised or something in the process. Then what? Then you sue me?
I've said this before, that middle ground between having a state like New Jersey and New York with a right to carry and having no one be able to defend themselves, deputizing people, former military, former law enforcement, etc., that could be a winning idea. Certainly do need help on the streets of New York. Thanks, guys.